Hi, my name is Anders Chamberlain. I'm 9 years old. I go to Shepherd of the Desert School. I have 2 brothers and 1 sister. I have helped out with my dad in special ministries. I know all the books of the Bible from scratch. I became a Christian on the ski lift at Arizona Snowball after I saw a bear at the age of 5. I understand Jesus died for me. I want to be baptized to show the world that I believe Jesus is my Savior. Hello, my name is Johnny Ray Chamberlain. I'm 6 years old and I go to Laguna Elementary School. I'm in kindergarten and my teacher is Mrs. Reck. I have 2 brothers and 1 older sister. I have chicks, chickens, and 2 dogs. I've helped out with my family at the church in the special ministries and I go to Awana. I always want to go to church every week and I hope not to get sick on a Sunday. I want to learn about Jesus. I love him because he died on the cross for me. I like that we can pray to God, and I hope I can read my Bible when I learn how to read. I look forward to going to heaven, and I want to get baptized because I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, good morning. My name is Ray Larson, and I'm the campus pastor for Grace Chapel that's just right next door. We don't have a baptismal at the chapel, so we just step on over here. Troy doesn't charge if we use this one. So it's my privilege to be here today. And there are 3 special things for this baptism today for me. One is I get to interact with the congregation of Grace Chapel, who I love. The chapel is a mixed group of people over there. We have 2 of our younger guys here today. That's one reason. Second reason is these 2 younger guys are my grandchildren, Anders and Johnny. So it's... great blessing to be involved in their baptism. The third reason is just because today is just a reminder to me of the goodness of God. Psalm 100, verse 5 says, God is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness is to all generations. This morning at the breakfast table, I was counting the generations of Larsons, where we have seen the faithfulness of God. And I've seen it starting in the late 1800s in Ilbecken, Sweden, Yarna Church, where my grandfather attended, right down through Scottsdale Bible Church today, 5 generations, and we've seen God's love and his faithfulness, and we continue to see that. We are so blessed and so thankful. Anders and Johnny have been here 1 other time, and that was when they were babies, and their parents dedicated them to the Lord here before the congregation. They committed there to raise their children so that they'll have opportunity to hear the gospel, so that they might come to know Christ at an early age. And the Lord's honored their prayer. The Lord has blessed them. I think 7 and 9 are early ages. So it's those are the 3 reasons this is a very special baptism for me. So based on your testimony of faith, Anders, I am very privileged today to baptize you now in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Good job, Anders. Step over there. Johnny, based on your testimony of faith in Christ, it's my pleasure today to now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let's go, Anders. I gotta go.
My name is Hannah Gross, and I am 14 years old, and I am homeschooled. I am a swimmer with Scottsdale Aquatic Club, and swimming is my passion. I grew up in a Christian home and went to a Christian school until 1st grade. I trusted Jesus as my Lord and Savior in kindergarten. I remember the day like it was yesterday. My teacher was telling us the importance of trusting in Jesus as soon as possible, since life is unpredictable. That day, I told my mom I wanted to pray to have Jesus with me for the rest of my life. That night with my parents, I asked Jesus to save me and be my Lord. My parents emailed my teacher the good news. The next day on the chalkboard, she drew a heart with a bunch of dots representing sin. She handed me the eraser, and I erased all the dots and wrote Jesus in the heart, representing Jesus taking over and totally forgiving me. I can't remember what life was like without Jesus, and I certainly cannot imagine my life without him. Knowing that this life is temporary and Jesus is forever is hard to imagine, but believing in God is all I need. My walk with God continues to grow with the help of my two group leaders. I want to be baptized today to show others that Jesus is my Lord and Savior.
Hi, my name is Justin Haig, and I am the junior high pastor. We've got Hannah here and Caitlin, and we are so excited. Beautiful testimony, just great words. And I'm so proud of you, and I'm excited to baptize you this morning. And so, Hannah, as you read out like your life and your testimony, is it your intention to live for Jesus for the rest of your life? Yeah, that's right. Good answer. Well, based on your profession of faith and your testimony and just now and the finished work that has been done on the cross, it's my honor to baptize you in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
My name is Cameron Tyke, and I am 25 years old. I come from a strong Christian home with two loving parents and three siblings that all grew up at Scottsdale Bible. I accepted Christ when I was 6 years old after my mother explained what it would mean for me to have Him guide me in everything that I do and provide comfort and strength when I would need it most. After that, I remember going to church every week and being part of everything that I could. I was surrounded by the love of Christ and was on fire for Him. While I had numerous opportunities to be baptized, I continued to push it off. As I got older, I strayed and knew that the path I was on was wrong, but I tried to justify what I was doing. I stopped asking God for guidance and took the weight of my life all on my own. I experienced extreme stress and anxiety. No matter how hard I tried, those feelings would come back, and I thought nothing could ever change. However, through the never-ending love of Christ, He drew me back into the church and introduced me to my beautiful fiance, who was also attending SBC. He was working in both of our lives, drawing us closer to Him. It is now, as I prepare for a lifetime with my future wife, that I am here to be baptized today to show my obedience to Jesus Christ and to publicly proclaim that I am ready to follow Him for the rest of my life.
My name is Caitlin Merlet, and I'm 26 years old. I grew up battling a chronic disease that caused pain, fatigue, memory loss, and speech impairment. During that time, even though I had two loving parents, as well as two sisters who were and are still my best friends, I felt alone. I experienced my darkest moments during those years, filled with anger, anxiety, self-hatred, and even self-harm. I felt trapped in a body I couldn't control, and feeling that my childhood had been taken away from me fueled my anger. I knew that to have hope for things to improve, I needed to turn to something bigger than myself. I needed Christ. With my parents' encouragement, I went to several churches, and I ended up finding my home at Scottsdale Bible. I started attending alone, and I was so overcome with relief that I cried the entire time. It was on that day that I accepted Jesus Christ as my Savior. Because of His unending mercy and love, I was given the gift of eternal life. It felt as though He had been preparing for many years to welcome me with open arms. I am not ashamed of my past because I believe that He was guiding me the entire time in leading me exactly where He wanted me to go. God led me to the man who is my best friend and who He chose to be my husband, and He led me here today to be baptized. I publicly proclaim that I have chosen to follow and be obedient to Jesus for the rest of my life.
Well, good morning, folks. My name is Brian McAnally, and I have the honor of being one of your pastors here at Scottsdale Bible Church. And it really is a great morning to be with you, to baptize Cameron and Caitlin together this morning. You know, Cameron's story is neat, too, because this is happening at a time where he just completed his graduate-level studies and now is moving on to his career. And in some ways, we can see that a similar picture with baptism, that baptism is not a finish line. It's really a starting point. It's a starting point of obedience and walking by faith, and something that God wants for every one of us. And Cameron's here today giving witness to his faith in Jesus as his Lord and Savior for his life going forward with Caitlin. Cameron, it is because of what Jesus Christ has accomplished on the cross for you. It's my honor to baptize you, my brother, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Congratulations, man.
Caitlin, looking around, it's very clear that when you cry tears of joy, that we have plenty who feel like nobody should have to cry alone. It is a happy day indeed, and then we celebrate with you. What a beautiful day God has given us. And Caitlin, it is because of what Jesus accomplished on the cross for you too. My dear sister, it's an honor to baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Congratulations.
My name is Christy Goble. I'm a wife, mother, hairstylist, homeschooler, and Clemson Tiger. I am the director of Paradise Valley Classical Conversations, a Christian homeschool community that has enriched my family's lives in ways too numerous to count. My husband is also a hairstylist, and we switch off days in our studio salon, so as a team, one of us is always with our children. I was baptized as a baby and grew up in Clemson, South Carolina, as part of a church-going family. I went to Sunday school, vacation Bible school, mission projects, but I didn't really know there was such a thing as a relationship with Christ. I always prayed and talked to God, but it wasn't until I was a young adult that I really leaned in and on Christ. I would talk to him and receive direction, peace, and answers. I began thanking him for all the everyday blessings in my life, and things shifted from religion to a relationship. Since then, I've lost both my parents and delivered a son, Gabriel, who was stillborn. Christ has continued to be my rock. Through all these trials, I thanked God for his presence in my life and have had many long talks. I have argued, challenged, listened, thanked, and obeyed him. When Pastor Jamie talked about religion moving to relationship, I knew I was there. I have a friend in Jesus who fills my life. I want to declare myself for him. I want my children to witness the beauty in having a relationship with Christ. I want to honor and obey. I have decided.
Hi, my name is Fallon Reese Goble. I am 10 years old. I pray each night before bed and before every meal because I believe in the Lord. The reason I would like to be baptized is I believe that Jesus is my Savior, and I want to have an even bigger relationship with him. I want to read the Bible, his blueprints, and build my life on him, the rock. Because when you build your life on anything else, it is like building on sand, and your life will crumble and fall. I want to be baptized to show everyone that I know God, and I am thankful for his great love for me.
Well, good morning. My name is Ryan Heath, and I'm the pastor of Children's Ministry. And Fallon, this is so exciting for you to be here with your mom, be able to be baptized together, to share the week before we celebrate Easter, your proclamation of belief that Jesus died and rose again for your sins.
Well, and Christy, it is a joy to do this as a family because it's such a wonderful picture of being a legacy of faith, a household of faith, where Jesus Christ is glorified. And because you are both here together, it really is my joy to baptize you, Christy.
And for me to baptize you, Fallon, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You guys can hug.
Hi, my name is Caitlin Whitmore. I am 8 years old. I live with my mom and dad, two sisters, one brother, and my puppy dog named Mocha. I like to sing, color, and do puzzles. I am in third grade, and I am homeschooled with my brother. When I was three, my mom was talking about what it means to trust in Jesus. After that, I told my sisters I wanted to pray, and they said to get on my knees and put my hands together. So I did, and I asked Jesus to forgive me from my sins and be my Savior. The verse I know best is, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him will not perish but have everlasting life." I know I will be in heaven with him one day and with my family, and that makes me smile. At dinner, we read the Bible together. I like to ask questions to know him more and learn how much God loves me and how I can be more like him. When I make a bad choice, God helps me to think about how he would treat someone or what he would say to someone and change my heart and mind about how to treat others. I want to be baptized today because I want to share my faith and love for Jesus.
Hi, my name is Rachel Whitmore. I'm 11 years old. I live with my mom and dad, two sisters, and one brother. I like horses, dolphins, rollerblading, swimming, and my family. I sing in the children's choir at church, and I like to sing with my sisters. I am in sixth grade and go to a Great Hearts Charter School called North Phoenix Preparatory. When I was five, I watched a video called The Story of Jesus for Children. After watching it, I told my mom I would like to pray to ask Jesus to forgive me for my sins and to be my Savior, and so I did. Now, if I am ever scared, I know that God is with me and He will protect me. One of my favorite verses is Joshua 1:5, because I like to remind myself that He will never leave me. I am getting baptized to show everyone that I believe and will follow Jesus for the rest of my life. Hi, my name is Abby Whitmore. I am 13 years old. I live with my parents, my siblings, and my dog. I am a seventh grader at North Phoenix Preparatory Academy. I enjoy swimming and singing in the children's choir with my sisters. I also have enjoyed volunteering in the five-year-old Sunday school class with Mr. and Mrs. Earl for 3 years now. I have come to really love and respect them and have grown in my faith because of them. When I was six, my mom signed me and my sister up for an after-school program called the Good News Club. Before I accepted Jesus, I knew who He was, but I didn't know how to be saved. At first, I was there for the snacks, but then I trusted in Jesus as the Lord of my life. After that, I was there because of my relationship with my Heavenly Father. Since then, I've been on fire for Jesus, even though I am shy. I try not to miss an opportunity to talk about God in everything I do. With God in my life, I feel unstoppable. If ever my faith is tested, He is with me through it all. With God in my life, I've been able to forgive those who have hurt me, and I am not afraid to stand up for what I believe in. This is why I am being baptized today, to show everyone that I have only one person on the throne of my life, and that person is my Lord, my King, my Savior, my friend, and my Father.
Well, Whitmore girls, it is so awesome to have you guys here. I've been to camps with you guys, getting ready to come to Camp 34 with you as well, and seeing your mom serve faithfully and your parents, and now just to see you guys, all three, want to be baptized together to just show your faith and love in Jesus Christ, and it is my privilege to do this. So, Caitlin, based on your testimony and based on the finished work of Jesus Christ on the cross, it's my privilege to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. And Rachel, you as well. I just love your spunky spirit, and you always just have that big smile that you can't even stop now. So the joy of Christ is just evident in your heart and in your life, and we love having you around. And based on your testimony and based on the finished work of Jesus Christ on the cross, it's my privilege to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. And Abby, you not only are a total rock star helping out with those five-year-olds, but then, actually, I can't tell. Well, as long as the kids don't know you're one of the puppets, then they're fine. So, because they're all real. In either case, we are so proud of you. And I am just excited to see how on fire you are for the Lord. And it is my privilege to baptize you based on the finished work of Jesus Christ on the cross. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
My name is Grace Crane. I am 7 years old, and I am in second grade at the Cherokee Elementary School. My dad's name is Andrew, my mom's name is Michelle, and I have a little sister named Bella. One day, we will get a dog, too. I have grown up knowing about Jesus because He's always been a part of my family. When I was lonely, He was there. When I cried, He was there to wipe my tears. When I was happy, He was there too. He has always loved me, and He is my friend forever. My parents asked if I have trusted Jesus as my Lord and Savior, and I told them yes. I want everyone to know that they don't have to be alone and that Jesus loves them, even if their room is dirty or if they're having a hard time making good choices. Following Jesus has helped me make good choices and love my friends better. I don't always do it right, but Jesus does, and I am glad he's always with me. I want to be baptized today to show the world how much Jesus loves me and how much he loves them too. My favorite verse is John 3:16 because I know that God loves us all so much that he sent his one and only son to die on the cross to pay for our sins so we can spend forever in heaven with him, with Jesus. He loves me that much, and he loves you that much too.
Well, Grace, I love that not only your name just represents God's love and his grace and forgiveness, but even in your testimony, just reminding everyone they're not alone, and even if the room's messy, God still loves them. And that is so sweet because that is just not only your name, but it's God's grace and forgiveness and acceptance. And it's so sweet that your father's here as well. And so based on your testimony and on the finished work of Jesus Christ on the cross, it's our privilege to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
My name is Bill Van Ooy, and I'm a retired Canadian snowbird living in Scottsdale in the winters. I am married for 30 years to my wife, Susan, and father to two children, Gregory and Kristen. Greg passed away 2.5 years ago, at which time I found Jesus, who came to me to help me through the grief, and I've never looked back. My life before I was saved was self-will and disconnection from others. I now feel loved and connected to all. It's truly a miracle. My baptism is my commitment to Jesus that I want him in my life forever.
My name is Susan Van Ooy. I live in Scottsdale with my husband, Bill, for part of the year to escape our cold winters in Canada. I'm a very proud mother of two beautiful children, my youngest child, Kristen, and my eldest, Greg, who died 2.5 years ago at the age of 27. I came to know in a much deeper way the power and comfort of God after being diagnosed with breast cancer 9 years ago. But it was only after the death of my son that I fully understood that I have eternal life, and for that, I am eternally grateful. The unfolding of God's plan for me has been truly miraculous. After being baptized as a baby, I am being baptized again today because I now understand its true meaning, and I'm joyful that I can be baptized as Jesus was. I'm here today to demonstrate my love for and devotion to my Savior, Jesus Christ.
Bill and Susan, your story is so poignant because it shows the reality of what it means to live the Christian life. Jesus comes to us in our time of needs. He walks with us and he is faithful. And you have truly seen beauty come from your ashes. And I love your story that you aren't looking back, that you're pressing forward. You're always cherishing what God has blessed you with, but you press forward towards the goal, which is found in Jesus. And so, Bill, it is because of what Jesus Christ has accomplished on the cross for you. It's my honor to baptize you, my brother, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. I want you to switch places here. And Susan, because Jesus Christ accomplished this good work for you and did it on the cross, it is my joy to baptize you, my sister, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Hi, my name is Vicki Holt. God has blessed me with 4 amazing sons and 5 beautiful grandchildren. I was raised in church and always knew that God loved me, but I had no understanding of the Bible. 4 years ago, my 25-year-old son Nick committed suicide, changing my life forever. I was totally lost and brokenhearted. I prayed constantly for God to help me survive this tragedy. The Lord answered my prayers and brought me a loving and understanding man, Danny. We moved to Arizona, and I was grateful for a new start away from the painful daily memories. I became friends with a wonderful woman named Leanne. We talked about God a lot. She told me about his grace and the work of the Holy Spirit. She helped me see that all this time I had not truly known the Lord in the way that he wanted me to know and love him. I knew that I wanted to have that relationship with my Heavenly Father. Leanne introduced me to Scottsdale Bible and invited me to attend a women's Bible study. Through these classes and Jamie's teachings, I am understanding the depth of God's grace and faithfulness, and most of all, his unconditional love. I know that living with the loss of my son will be a never-ending struggle, but I now know that I will never be alone, according to the promise of Isaiah 41:10, which says, "Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." I'm being baptized today to show my love for and faith in Jesus.
Vicki, your story is indeed poignant, and it comes from a very tender spot, but boy, what a good God. And Leanne was intending to be here and just wasn't able to, and I know she's watching us through our technology, and I know she's supporting you in spirit as well. And boy, I love that part of your story too is the love and support that you found at Scottsdale Bible Church. So it's my joy to baptize you, Vicki. It really, really is. And it is because of the finished work of Jesus Christ, what he accomplished for you on the cross, that I get to do this. And I do so in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
My name is Sue Sterling. I married my sweetheart of 18 years last August. Margie Galloway married us at Greyhawk, where Tommy and I met playing golf all those years ago. My mother lives in Rio Verde and at 101 years old is still going strong. I have one son in Idaho and a brother in Colorado. I grew up in northern Minnesota, where I was baptized as an infant, attended Sunday school, church camp, and 2 years of confirmation. I renewed my relationship with Jesus in 2008 while watching a woman tell of her story of salvation in an online Christian program. Through my tears and the peace in my heart, I knew that my life had changed and that Jesus was definitely my Savior. I've been attending Scottsdale Bible Church since 1989, and within the last 4 years, became a member, attended numerous classes, and completed the Women in Leadership Development training last year. As a result, I've become deeply involved in the art ministry workshops. It is such a blessing to have all this available, including the wonderful SBC family. I'm a new person in Christ. At every step, he has placed people in my life who inspire me, encourage me, and are role models. My mission statement through WILD is, I exist to serve by spreading kindness for the glory of God. Galatians 5:22 reminds us, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness. My baptism today is a personal affirmation of my obedience to our Lord and a very exciting and joyful step in my faith. I'm professing to those around me that I am a child of God.
Well, I tell you, it's been a joy to know Sue. Sue's kind of, we've had touch points along the way, got to know her in launch and some Bible study classes, and it's really just been incredible to see your faith blossom over the last particular year, a couple years in particular, and it really is just a joy to get to share in this moment with you. And I know that Margie from Hawaii is enjoying this for you as well. It really is a special day, and we rejoice with you, Sue. And I would like to, just one last comment, and that is that the kindness that you get to show, you understand. And we hope you all connect the dots too, that this is an overflow of God's Holy Spirit in you, and that you are able to be kind because God has shown his kindness to you. And Sue, it's because of what Jesus Christ accomplished for you on the cross that it's my honor to baptize you, my sister, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.